if as a designer, if you're focused on designing software, or an industrial designer, you are designing the artifact, but what about the ambience in which people are going to deliver healthcare, and that heavily influence the experience? And I'll share some example of how it influenced and what we have done to kind of improve that situation. So we as a design team focus on process, product, and ambience, and by doing this, we not only create the complete experience, we also ensure that, you know, it leads to a growth. So at the end, it helps the caregiver to grow as well as an organization to deliver value, and it also kind of leads to into economic value, which is important to keep kind of doing and keep delivering the healthcare services. So I'll give some example. One example, I'll start with a product, and I'll talk about all the examples, you know, different elements which I talked about. I'll start with a product example. So this example is a warmer example, and what you see here was the current state of a baby warmer in one of the PHC. So the warmer is nothing but when there are infant, newborn babies who are very, very tiny, do not have, you know, enough kind of strength to keep themselves warm. They need external source heating to maintain the required temperature to survive. Otherwise, if they don't get the required temperature, babies will die. Very simple. So what people do is they just put one light bulb, and then whatever heat comes through that, that's the source of heat for them, and sometimes bulb burst and babies die. So that's the kind of current state of the warmer, and that's how, you know, babies are kept under the light bulb. So we said, okay, this is something which we need to do. We need to tackle this problem. And why it is so serious? Because again, like I mentioned in the beginning, 27 million newborn in a year, 47 per thousand babies die in a year of birth, and 0.8 million newborn baby die within 28 days. Because this is the kind of situation we are living in. And now as a design team, we actually think that, okay, experience design, and what it means in this context. Suddenly it kind of changes the perspective, and the notion, people who join our group, when you say experience design, they come with some kind of a preconceived notion that, okay, something really cool and funky is kind of will create the experience. But here actually the whole context, but at the end you create the right experience. So, you know, I just trying to sort of see the whole experience piece in a little different way. So even, you know, for us as a company, it was a different, you know, journey. So when we started kind of getting into this space, the approach was, we as a, you know, big MNC, we do have product which are sold in Europe and US, which are very expensive and can do everything, can solve every problem, but they're very expensive. So the first thing which comes is, okay, take out certain feature and reduce the price so that people can buy it, and then we will be able to solve the problem. But purely from a you know, design thinking, what we realize is, if you just take out the feature and price, it is not going to solve the problem. Because the environment and the context in which it is expected to operate is very different. Here we are talking about a very different environment where you need something which is very rugged. User-friendly here is not a very generic term, because the people who are going to use are not trained professionals. So in fact, actually it becomes extremely important and becomes a key criteria for your device to succeed. And the different kind of the power condition, portability, affordability, serviceability. So here the experience actually for people who are going to buy it is very different. If, you know, if they get something which does not require any kind of assembly, which does not require a service engineer to come and install, which does not, if something goes wrong, they are able to fix it quickly, is what the right experience for them. Whereas what happens in the one here is, you know, this is something a very highly sophisticated warmer and incubator. Just press off a button, something just slides up, it folds out, and you know, it looks really nice, and then you can close it. And the people in US and Europe, they get the right experience, because, you know, feel that my baby is very comfortable, just a press of button, nurse comes and it opens, you can take out the baby. You cannot, but if you understand the kind of a context here, the experience, the definition of experience here is very different. People are not worried about that on a touch of a button, whether it moves up or down. They are just worried if something goes wrong, who is going to fix it? So, you know, we do have a premium, the example which I showed you, the first two warmer, where the comfort, convenience, full feature, premium aesthetics, is the thing which create the right experience for people who are paying and you know who can afford. But when you see in the different contexts, it's about affordability, whether can I have my, because if my baby is in the barber, I should be, you know, there's a cost to it. So where am I able to afford it? If I'm able to afford and save my baby, that's a great experience for me. People who are using it, it is rugged, serviceability, no issues with the power. Power goes off, it works. Each number of fluctuation, it works. That's the experience for them. What remains kind of central to both is patient safety, clinical accuracy, and empathy with the people. Again, I was so, and the one more thing which we realize in this whole process is, you know, the cost is not the parameter to create the experience or making it kind of a suitable in the context. Like, you will see some of the warmer actually there in the PHC are just 9, and those were donated, so those were free. So there were no costs associated with it. So like completely free, given by some NGO, but not working because nobody knows how to use it. If something goes wrong, nobody's there to fix it. The midwife has no idea what to do with this, you know. And so the costs, we realize that cost is just not, cannot solve the problem, because even if you give it free, after some time you will see it is lying out there and nobody's using it. And this kind of a thing which looks very crude because it was done by some kind of a roadside fabricator, but they were very happy because they know that if something goes wrong, they'll just call, please come and fix it, he'll come and fix it. So although, you know, so things like this is what kind of, when the context change and in terms of experience, this is what matters to people in that different context. So it is not only about the cost, it is about awareness, training and maintenance. When you start thinking about all of this, that is where the definition of experience kind of changes, and then you start looking at the overall picture. And if you kind of cater to all three, and that is where you can actually create the impact. So not with the product, but the moment you start plugging in all other pieces, that is where this whole experience can actually lead to impact on the ground. So like, you know, people talk about the user manual and serviceability, and that's the kind of a lady who is going to use it. So you can imagine, you know, whether she can understand the user manual, whether she will fix it. That's the kind of a place where it is going to get installed. And that's the kind of people who are going to purchase. So how, you know, so unless you fix your issues related to purchase, installation, and you know, it just cannot create the impact. So when we talk about the experience, we actually include this, all this kind of a complete touch points, which leads to a complete experience in the context of a product. So awareness, purchase, install, training, in-use, maintenance, upsell, unless you kind of focus on all these aspects, your design or your intended experience will never lead to any kind of a concrete outcome or desired outcome. So on the one side, in the Western world, this is what you have, which is like completely full featured, you have everything kind of hooked to a baby. The other side, you have a, you know, just one light bulb trying to give some heat. And then what we did is a warmer, which solves the 80% of the problems. It may not have all the sophisticated thing which is needed, and it is not as good as the bulb. It has all the essential thing from a clinical safety and clinical accuracy, and it can address the 80% of the problem. And then plus it has many other advantage compared to even a full featured warmer. So maybe I won't go into detail because that's not the intent of this talk. The intent of the talk is to bring different elements which lead to experience. I do have several other details which, you know, kind of makes it more suitable in that context. I'll just skip. So by the way, this warmer was extremely successful and doing pretty good, adding value in terms of saving lives of babies, and from an organization it is creating a lot of economic value as well. So other thing which I want to talk about, so now we touched upon the product and in what kind of a context and what is the definition of experience in that context. The other element which we look at, the whole ambience. So now what you see is the ambience of a cath lab, where you know about the cath lab, right, where they do angioplasty and angiography. So if there is a cardiac patient, he's gone through heart attack, he has a block, and then they will kind of put the catheter and, you know, put a stent there. So the patient lies down on a bed, and then there's a C-arm where they monitor the position of a stent and so on and so forth. But look at the whole ambience. So if you see the ambience, you can clearly make out, like, you know, if somebody has cardiac arrest, he would never want to go for his procedure in that place. I mean, if you go in the actual place, even if you don't have a problem, maybe once you go there, maybe you may get attacked. So it's kind of really, really scary in terms of the way the whole thing is organized, the way the storage is done, the way the lighting is done, the way the cabling is done. And this is a kind of a big hospital, you know, where the gas lab is installed. So we said, fine, we have created the right experience when we were talking about the product. So CR, it's a GCR, and it is perfect. It gives you the right image. People can use it. It's a perfect product. Create the right experience. But now when it goes in this ambience, the whole thing is gone. The patient gets scared. It's the most scary thing for him to enter into this kind of a cath lab environment. The clinician gets stressed. He becomes less efficient. So again, you know, you just cannot solve the problem if you're talking about the complete experience through product. You need to see the whole ecosystem, which includes the ambience. We said, no, we need to do something about it. So we went there, we observed, and then we came up with a new design. So I'll share that how the new design looks like. And hopefully there will be audio, which, so the audio is not working. Is there a way you can make audio work? Okay, so that's the new ambience in the same space. This is how the new ambience looks like. And it completely takes away the stress.
This whole atmosphere, the ambience of this lab is very soothing, very nice, very relaxing. And at the same time, it looks very high-tech. So when an outsider enters the cath lab, he probably gets a feeling that I'm entering into a very, you know, cutting-edge technology lab, which is very good, very state-of-the-art, very latest.
Cardiologist, or as especially as an interventionist, we want that we should work on a very relaxed and very comfortable situation. And I think the ambience is providing both to us. So it's very important. And we didn't realize that it's so important.
So when we redid the whole ambience, the very interesting feedback we got, patients were obviously much more relaxed and calm. At the same time, clinicians said, okay, we also now feel much more relaxed because our patients are relaxed. So suddenly, the moment you combine your device and the whole ambience, it changes the whole experience and leads to a better clinical outcome. We have applied a similar thing in, so this is how the new ambience, if you compare, this is what it used to look like, this is how it looks like now, which leads to a far better experience and improved clinical outcome. Now, so we have applied this concept of positive distraction. In sense, when the patient walks in a place, the whole ambience looks very intimidating and they get further stressed. They already are stressed because they have been diagnosed with something. Plus, the whole ambience and the atmosphere create a lot more stress. So this is a typical ambience for MR. And this is kind of a place. It looks kind of very scary because it's dark and things like that. So we said, okay, what we need to do is just take away their mind from this feeling that, oh, I'm going to get into this bore and it is very claustrophobic and so forth. So let's create something very positive, something very dramatic, which they associate with something positive. So this is how the new ambience looks like. It is there in one of the hospital in Delhi. And suddenly, when people walk in, they say, wow, what is that? You know, it looks very good.
Which hospital, if you can just...
Yeah, it's a Mahajan clinic.
Okay.
So Dr. Mahajan is one of the sort of world-renowned radiologists. He is a consultant to PM. So that is where we have done this. And the moment patient walks in, they find themselves in a completely different environment, though they don't think that they are going through a medical procedure. And that takes away the effect. No matter how much you explain, they know, sir, nothing will happen, just lie down. They keep thinking about it. But the moment they enter into a space which is very different, it kind of creates a positive distraction and helps in reducing the anxiety. I'll share some more example where it has worked really, really well. So we as an adult also get scared. I have also been through MRI and it's a scary experience. You actually feel that whether I will be able to come out of this bore or not, what is going to happen. So it's extremely scary. I hope you have not gone through that process. But yeah, it is not something which one would want to do. So So you can imagine when we as an adult feel terrified so much, what would happen to kids? So they really get scared. And the challenge is when they are scared, they move and they resist. And if the kids are moving, their image won't come correct. And they will have to go through the process. Then it delays the process and it just creates a lot of problems. It takes longer time, the image quality is not good. And so what they do is they sedate. So they, you know, give them injections so that they lie down, they sleep for, and then it takes, they feel drowsy once they get up after a couple of hours and so on and so forth. It leads to a lot of problem, it takes longer time. So what we did is we actually looked through the eyes of a child. So, you know, a kind of a cognitive walkthrough from the eyes of a child. So when kids enter, this is how the CT looks like to him, you know, because this small kid looking at it, then he says, oh my God, this is where I have to enter. So we said, okay, let's reimagine the whole experience and create a story which will have again positive distraction for him. And this is how the new space looks like. So when the kids enter, this is what it looks like. And it is not that ambience, you know, what we do is we actually create again like complete experience. So from that point, kids take an appointment, his parents take an appointment, they have been given a, you know, a storybook which has the similar character. They have been given a drawing book so they can draw and things like that, and there is a CD which they want. So there is a story which gets created, and actually what happens in the process, they actually look forward to their appointment for scanning, because there is a story, and that story says on that day you will get to enter a spaceship, and we will be going to a spaceship. And he's reading a story, and the last phase of that story is entering into kind of a spaceship. That's a curiosity has been built in. Nurses have been trained to what to tell. So nurses don't tell that, okay, this is an MR scan room. They say it's a cable car ride, it's a spaceship room. So the whole signage, the communication between nurse and patient, nurse and kids, and you know, the kind of interaction which happens, the whole thing has been planned so that when the kids walk in, they see spaces like this. And what nurses would tell him, okay, you are entering into a spaceship, there are other enemies, aliens will attach, so you hold on tight, you know, you don't have to move, and you have to try, hold it, and then the kids actually do that. So when we did the first test, and the kids who came out said, Mama, can I go one more time? So that's the kind of impact the whole ambience and the experience which was created did to the kids, people, and it reduced the sedation rate by 70%. So there is a quantitative data which tells now the sedation rate has gone down by 70%. So that's the kind of impact and you just cannot do it just by the device. You know, you cannot, no matter how well you design the interface, no matter how well you design the product, unless you look at the whole experience, what goes on the people's mind. And we also did, you know, not only the point, again, you know, if suddenly if you enter, it may not create that excitement for a kid, you know. So there is a story and there is an interaction, people to people interaction, the ambience and a product, and all this leads to a better clinical outcome, and that's what the whole experience can do. So there are many such examples where this thing is working really, really well. And the last thing is about process. So it may not sound as interesting as the earlier example, but again, it's extremely important in the context of creating the complete experience. So what we do is we actually invite our customers at our studio. This is the image of our studio where we engage them in the process and go through the entire journey of what they go through. And then we kind of create, do a co-creation, we do workshop with them to you know, create ideas, and we actually go there and map out their complete flow of how they are doing things, and then we ideate as to what we can do to improve the patient experience, efficiency, and the. This again is an image in our studio where we have mapped out their complete flow map. So what you see, all the yellow thing here are the statement and the problems which people have mentioned, either caregiver or patient. So this is the kind of a problem we go through. This has different levels of flow. So what happens on this floor, then you come here, this is what you do, and this is the time it takes. And then, so you actually make up the complete flow, and then it helps you to optimize the flow, because the process again plays a very important role in terms of defining the experience. We create the whole sort of model of the, you can't see in this projector, but it is actually a sort of a 3D model of the hospital where we plot how they move around and what happens, so that even with relation to physical space, we understand what kind of intervention we need to do from a design perspective. So, and then once you look at this whole thing, it actually leads to a great, not only the right experience and deliver the quality care, even from an organization perspective, it leads to a great business because you are actually helping customer to create outcome, create desired outcome and achieve his goal. So, and it actually helps in, you know, improving the sort of top line and things like that, and leads to a economic value for the organization as well as for the customer. So that's kind of pretty much I had. We had a 5:30, so we're almost there. And this is the image of our studio. That's the our team. These are some of the images I thought I'll just share with the studio. The kind of setup where we allow our partner customer to come and kind of create ideas. We use this wall again as a visualization tool to understand the customer's problem. So I think, yeah, that's pretty much. I would like to hear from you if there's anything which kind of with you in terms of the domain in which you operate and different elements there which can lead to a better outcome. So if you have any thought of what would create a complete experience in your own context, then I would be interested to hear that.
I have a few questions. Okay. So you talk about the experience of the kids, and that's okay, like if it's an exclusive thing for kids, but not of the art as a software. It'll be used by multiple type of people. So we can't show an orange screen for somebody and some pink screen for somebody and green screen for somebody. So in that context, I'm not able to relate how I do that in our world.
Yeah, so the point here is, you know, not look at this one element. The point is, if you're creating a software, what is the outcome that software is going to create and what is the definition of experience in the context? Like the Barmer example which I showed you, it was a very basic skeleton thing, because that is what the definition of experience in that context is. Rugged, serviceable, simple, clean, nothing else. So the point is, how do you define your experience and how do you look at the end outcome? And whether you understand the relationship of how this software, whether the software alone will be able to solve the problem.